Oh, hi, this is Ann Clemmer, and it's time for one of those unmentionable videos. You know, the ones that you want to ask people those questions, but you're afraid to ask because you think everybody knows. Well, get ready, because we're going to cover one of those subjects right now. So what's this? Hey, it's a Stampin' Up! Roller Wheel! And a lot of you have been asking how to use it. It comes in three parts. There's a jumbo wheel, and there's an ink cartridge, and then there's a handle. And the ink cartridge goes in just like this, and you're going to push it down onto the spindle. And then you want to push the jumbo roller wheel in until it snaps into place. And there you have it. Standard roller wheel works the same, and you just pull out the cover from the ink cartridge, press this, and all the way up into the roller wheel, and that's how it works. But first of all, we have to go and prime the pump. So there you go, run it a couple times across some scratch piece of paper. Now there's three ways to hold a roller wheel. The first way is to put an index finger across the center of the wheel and roll it. The second is to put two fingers across the wheel. Well, the third, put your whole hand over the roller wheel cover to give you more control. And it's always best to do it standing up. You can roll forward or you can roll backward. You just don't want to roll back and forth. So here we are with our cart, and you want to start from the top, but that's really not the best way. The best way is to start from the bottom corner closest to you and roll at a diagonal, and it won't show so much if you don't do it exactly perfect, because this isn't for perfection, it's for coverage. And with an ink cartridge in there, you can roll from my house to your house. It really works out well. So here's another way to do it without a roller wheel. It's not my favorite way, but it can be done. We're going to put Island Indigo and use the pad on some pool party cardstock. Now you want to roll the jumbo wheel across the ink pad over and over again, not back and forth, but in a circle, and much more than what I did here. And you want to make sure it's covered. Now, do you have one of these? If you don't have one of these, anything that's straight and raised will help. And just lay it by where you want to put the straight line, and make sure that the seam is out of the picture. Then lay it down against your straight edge and right across, and there you have it, straight as an arrow. Gotta love that. But then, of course, there's that ink cartridge, and I really like that better. So here you go. Make sure you put it away nicely. You're going to go and put the cover back on the ink cartridge. And then when you store these, always make sure that you're storing them handle down, because if you store it on the rubber, you could create a flat spot, and that's not the way you want to do it. And remember to clean them off. Get the excess ink off, and then rub it on the wet side, and then rub it on the dry side, and there you have it. It's done. This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from stamperdog.com, just trying to put a little ink, paper, and fun into your day.